All right. You little cat off handsome. Yeah. You're good. Hello. Hello, buddy. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Good boy. You ready? Okay. You sure? You sure you want to go get handsome? All right, here we go. Come on. Let's go. Come on. Good boy. So we're going to start with carding his hair and getting the loose undercoat out with an Andis undercoat rake, holding the skin taut, dragging the undercoat rake through his coat in the direction that the hair grows. You don't want to go against the lay of the coat. And you don't want to do this too hard, and you don't want to do it too long. When you stop feeling a bit of drag in the coat from the tool, stop. Because that's when you'll start scraping skin. As long as you feel a little bit of a drag and pull into the coat, you're actually grabbing out undercoat. Remember, it's thicker in the neck and in the haunches. Laddie is a wheaten colored Scotty. You guys who have been following my channel for a while have seen him grow up. The very first haircut I did with him, where you guys saw it, was probably at 4 months old, 16 weeks. He was a little baby. So cute. He's always been the bestest boy. Isn't that right? You've been the bestest boy? His eyebrows are a hair shorter than I normally like them. We're gonna grow those out. Once I start feeling this tool just glide through the coat, I stop working with this and I switch to a carding knife, holding the carding knife at a 45 degree angle and holding the skin taut. I get some more undercoat out. Because this is going to get what the other tool left behind. And you people who have pet Scotty that have them professionally groomed, you can still do this on your dog once a week. Get all this shedding hair out and keep your dog really nice looking all the time. And keep their coat and skin really, really healthy. Do this every time you wash your dog, every time you brush your dog. Really a good thing to do. Catch a puppy. And again, don't overdo it with this tool either. Now I'm going to use a 7-blade and trim his cheeks. You notice I don't use a 10 on the cheeks or throat of this breed. I feel it's too close. I want to leave a nice coating of hair. Good boy. And again, just like his sister, I'm staying out of the cowlicks, out of the hair going in the opposite direction. I'm going to do that with a 5-blade. And the darker colored one, I did the top of the skull with a 7. This one, I'm going to do the top of the skull with a 5. With the dark colored one, I arced out around the eyebrows with a 5. With this one, I'm going to use a 4. Because with this lighter color, it's going to look balded if you go too short. Also, these lighter colors tend to irritate from the clippers easier than a darker colored dog does. So I'm going to go from the middle of the ear down to the shoulder blade with the 5. Okay. I'm going to flatten out the back end with the 5. And come up the back side of the tail with the 5. Now we're going to switch to a 4. He's your good boy. Work out around the eyebrows with the 4. Now, I'm going to go back to a 7-blade. I'm going to do the outside of the ears with a 7. So this is a 4-in-1 7-blade, and it actually cuts to about the same length as an A5 style 8.5, which is going to leave a nice plush coating on the back of these ears, stay on top of the undercoat, and not make them look choppy or funky. So if you were to cut into these with the 10 blade, you're going to go under that undercoat and they're going to be a lot lighter colored and they're not going to have that plushness, which I think is very important when dealing with this kind of coat. Going to clean out right at the ear opening. Go back over these some after the bath. Now I'm going to switch to a 10 blade. You can wait there. You're fine. There. Gonna do the inside of the ears. halfway up because we're leaving this entire tuft area filled in the dip here and on the inside of the ear up to here. I have a detailed ear trimming video that I will link at the end of this one to help you with some more tips and tricks on trimming ears and Scotty ears and all types of ears and doing it safely. Now I'm going to use a 15 on the pads of his feet. You notice I'm just staying one blade length longer on everything for him. Good boy. Get my mess cleaned up here and go put this boy in the tubs. Yes, he can go in the tubs. Yes, he can get a bath, yes. Just the handsomest boy ever. And this Roseanne loves you. Yes, she does. I've always loved you, Daddy. I'm a terrier person at heart. Love everything terriers. You see me with poodles and a Yorkie, but I'm a terrier person. Just saying. Love the personality of terriers. They're spunky and sweet and sensitive and ferocious and kind and tenacious, and they have a double may care attitude. It's like, whatever. But they're so sweet and sensitive. And to train a terrier to work with you, you must have a soft hand. Everybody thinks they're so pushy and bully and mean, and that you've got to handle them, you've got to be hard on them. No. You watch my terriers coming into my salon, they are the sweetest, kindest, best behaved dogs. And that's because I have a soft hand. And I understand the personality. If they don't want something done, you've got to make it and think it's their idea to do it.
He got me. I'm wet. The hair, the clothes, the floor, my pants, my shoes. I'm wet. I don't know who to dry off first. Me or him. Going to put Betoquinol ear cleansing solution in the ears to dry up any moisture that might have gotten into the ears and loosen up wax and debris. Massage the base of the ear and let him shake it out.
Big valley.
Now we're going to go get Mr. Man dried. So this is a breed you should never, ever, ever just let air dry or cage dry if you expect to get a nice finish. If you air dry or cage dry this kind of dog with this kind of coat, unless you shave it real short, you're going to have hair flipping in all different directions and you're going to be very unhappy with the finish. And it's going to look real choppy to you. And even when you try to go back over and cut for it shorter, all the hair is going to be going in all kinds of different directions. So blow drying it straight from the tub, keeping everything going in the direction you want it to lie, is the way to go. All right, we're going to go put him in the tumble dryer. You ready? Huh? You ready? I think he's ready. All right, let's go.
He loves a boy. Without this. Start with going over the inside of the ears with a 10 blade. Now I'm going to go over the outside edges of the ears with the 10. But not the plush area that I want to keep that I did with the 7 earlier. Just the edges. Good boy. He's a good boy. Next, I'm going to switch to my 5 blade. Go over the 5 blade work. I'm also going to run the carding knife over his coat again real quick now that this is loosened up from the bath and see if I can get this to lie flatter. Now go to the 5 blade. I'm gonna go over the sides of the neck, the top skull, the chest. Corners of the eyes, just a touch.
And right in here on his top line. And going to flatten out his back end a little bit. And up the back of the tail. Now I'm going to switch to a four glide. Carve out around the eyebrows. The edges of the beard. And see what needs cleaning up on the body. That's a nice bowl. Where am I going, baby? I lost my comb. Well, that's weird. Eyebrows. You notice I left him well filled below the eyes, trimming that short would look totally silly on him. So he's got a nice coating of hair in here. Edge out around the ears. My sweet boy. Fold the ears in half. Trim off anything off the outside there. It falls past the outside of the ear. Perk them up and see if they look even at the top of the tufts. Tufts. Tuft. T-U-F-T. Tuft. Yes, tuft. You have tufts. Now we're going to scissor around the faces. I'm being silly. I need to stop. Must be serious. Yes. Must be a serious dog groomer. Turn, turn. Turn, turn.
usually with Scotties, I'll roll the skin off to the side on the tail. That'll oftentimes make any hair that is going to fall out of line when they're running around on the floor become evident. He's a handsome fella, isn't he? Hi guys, I am here with Paisley, the Scottish Terrier, and she is going to get a breed profile haircut. She actually is a brindle under here, but I don't want to expose her brindle coloring. Once you do, you have a separation of coloring from the top to the bottom. If she were hand stripped, the brindle would pull through in nice hard wiry coat. But being she's clippered, it's softer hair. And so it only shows up in the undercoat, and the undercoat stays black. As I start her, in order to keep her coat as healthy as possible, I'm going to use an Andis undercoat rake. And I'm going to rake out as much of the undercoat as I can without irritating her skin. So I'm gently pulling this in the direction that the hair grows only. Do not go against the grain or against the coat growth pattern, because if you do, this tool will cut hair. If it's used in the right direction, it will simply remove the undercoat. And many times with these Scotties, while I am not hand stripping, I am encouraging as good a coat as possible. And I oftentimes don't need to clipper the back, because once you get as much as you can of this undercoat out, the coat and on the back is lying beautifully flat and it looks great. One thing you'll notice though when you're working on these dogs is their coat looks nice and tight and flat before the bath, and you work with this coat and you lift up all this undercoat and get it out of here and you're like, oh my gosh, this coat looks perfect. Then you give them a bath. When you give them a bath, the coat becomes light and fluffy and flips up all over the place. And being I only have this dog in my salon for about an hour, I don't have time to blanket her or towel her to cause the coat to lie flat again. So washing this coat tight causes the hair to become flyaway. The reason for that is with the natural oils in the coat, it gives the hair some firmness and tightness to lay down. Once it's washed, you strip some of those oils off and the hair becomes flyaway. If the coat looks really, really, really good before the bath and you wash it and it becomes flyaway, you can either towel it or blanket it, which I don't have time to do during a regular grooming appointment, but if you're a pet parent and you want it to look good really fast, you can blanket it when you get them home. And that's just taking a towel and wrapping it over, fastening it here and fastening it under here, and letting it just hold this hair down. Or even a dog coat, putting a dog coat on them for maybe, you know, several hours after the groom, maybe overnight. That's what they do with show dogs if they have to wash them. Or after the bath, you can just go ahead and clipper it shorter. Or, you know. Just decide what's best. For this dog, it's best to try not to clip her into this if I can get away with it because of her brindle coloring. I am going to clip her. I am carding the coat right now, holding the carding knife at a 45 degree angle, holding the skin taut and dragging the carding knife through the coat. And this is simply lifting up more and more and more of this undercoat that's shedding out. So I will do some clipper work on her. Again, this is not considered hand stripping. This is carding. Of course, many terrier and stripping enthusiasts do consider carding and hand stripping one and the same. It's just like different variations of the same idea. For me, I consider hand stripping literally removing coat, usually thumb and forefinger, sometimes tools. But, you know, some breeds like spaniels and such, the carding is the hand stripping. All right, I don't want to overdo it before the bath. I want to do some of this after the bath as well. Get as much as I can out before the bath though. Free up all these follicles. Now we're gonna do some pre-bath clipper work. You're a good girl. Let's get this off of here. It's making noise and it's driving me crazy. Crazy, I tell you, crazy. All right, so. For your clipper work, Miss Paisley. Miss Paisley. Yes, I love you, Paisley. Unfortunately, these black dogs don't show up very good on camera. I try, but it's not too awful bad, I guess. So what I'm going to do with her is first, I need a 7-blade. I'm gonna do her cheeks and the front of her throat with the 7-blade. I'm staying in front of the cowlicks at the side of the neck. I don't want to go into those cowlicks because that'll clipper her too close and really expose those brindle markings, which I do not want to do. I'm going to do the flat of her top knot skull here. It's not really a top knot, it's a skull. I am not carving around the eyebrows at this time. I'm gonna do the very bottom back of the ears. If you want more detailed instruction on clipping the ears and doing Scotty Tufts, I will post a link at the end of this video on ear trimming. This video will be two Scotties, a wheaten color, and this one. It's Laddie and Paisley. They belong to the same pet parent. Now, I know I see you, honey. I love you. I do. Look at that smile. Oh, look at your smile. Oh, she got that Scotty smile.
All right, I'm going to clipper the outside of the ears with a 10, the inside of the ears with a 15, and the pads of the feet with a 30. I love you, baby. Clippering the actual opening of the ear, all up the outside edge of the ear, and the top half of the ear, leaving the tuft on the inside edge. Next, I'm going to do the sides of the neck with a 5 blade. I love you, Paisley.
I do. You want to come home with me? You want to come home with me? Okay, you can do that.
So from the middle of the ear down to just in front of the shoulder blade, we're going to put the sides of the neck nice and tight. And there you can see that lighter color showing through.
Let's go put you in the tub, Missy Ma'am.
Terrible.
He's absolutely terrible, huh? Yeah. Poor, poor Scotty. Poor, poor Scotty dog. Poor, poor Scotty dog. Have you been playing in the yard? Hmm.
I'm going to use my scrubby brush to loosen up more coat. Because these dogs have a soft undercoat and a harder outer coat, you want to get as much of that soft undercoat out of the follicle as possible to encourage some of the harder, darker color to grow through. And it makes a much healthier coat and skin. You can do this right down into the thighs, all the way down into the longer hair. Also, feels like a massage and gets them good and clean. I'm wet. For these coats that I don't want to overly soften, I use Chris Christensen After Bath. It's a really nice final rinse for the dogs. Doesn't overly soften the coat. It helps to remove any of the shampoo residue. And it is good for the coat and skin.
No, I know. You're the poor, poor puppy. You're the poor, poor puppy.
I'm going to work this in.
And you take this.
Get access to the neck hair here. On these dogs, the undercoat grows the thickest on the neck and on the thighs. So you want to pay a little extra attention to those areas when you're trying to get coat out. And a word of advice, some people recommend using your carding tools in the tub. I do not, ever. Because the skin is really, really soft while they're in the tub, and you can make them raw very, very fast. And you don't even know you're doing it. So no carding knife, no stripping tools in the tub at all. No furminators, would never even use a slicker brush in the tub, ever. Like, ever. But that's just me. put some ear wash in the ears to dry out any moisture that might have gotten in the ears, loosen wax and debris. She doesn't appreciate this. So when you have a strong dog like a Scotty really fighting you on it, fold the ear over the head completely. Then you're going to put the ear wash in from a little higher up. Like so. Fold it completely over. Open it. She's on to me. Open it up. Squirt it in. Good girl.
She's like, get that out of my ears. I don't want that in my ears.
All right. You want to go dry yourself off while I disinfect the tub? Mm-hmm. Let's do that. I'm going to put her up in her run for just a moment and let her kind of just go crazy. And you guys can watch her go crazy. This is the tumble dry setting.
Don't let me interrupt you, Paisley. Get the job done. Get the job done, Paisley. What, you wanna come out now? Okay. Okay.
Tumble dry setting over.
Tumble dry setting over. You ready? Okay, come on.
To the drying table.
You're all right. Good girl. Good puppy. You're all right. Good girl. It's okay. Alrighty, let's go over your body. That's a good girl. You shouldn't need this because you're a good girl. Try to lay all this coat back down. So being this is a clippered trim, if she were black, I would try to level out her top line a little better with graduation of lengths of hair. If she were hand stripped, it'd be the same thing. Just fashioning the hair through hand stripping to be tighter in some areas than others. But being she's a clippered pet and she has the wheaten coloring, I'm not gonna worry too much about that because if I graduate the lengths in here, you're gonna have an area here where you see the brindle and then the rest is gonna look nice and black. So I'm gonna go back over the sides of her neck with the 5-blade. Flatten the back end up a little bit. Come up the back side of the tail. Now I'm going to switch to a 4-blade. come in through the shoulders. I'm gonna see if I can flatten this out without messing it up. Yeah, that looks nice. Because the hair is thicker in the thighs, this blade will catch and show through the brindle hair, so I'm gonna skip that. Normally I'd come down through here a bit, but for her, no. Laying quite flat, looks good. Scissors, the eyebrows. Turn the corners of the eyes. Scissor the edges of the ears, hold still. Going to comb the beard forward. What I do is I just hold it in my hands, and anything poking out past the side of the cheek gets snipped off. Now I'm going to fold the ear in half. Anything that comes out the outside of the ear gets snipped off. Perk the ears up. Make sure they look nice and even side to side. I know you got a tangle. Around the feet. Fun fact, the Scotties' back feet should be smaller than their front feet. Just neatening her up all around the edges.